Let sigma n be the sum of divisors of n. In this video, I'm going to find number 1, sigma 12, number 2, sigma 2022. So to answer that question there, I'll start by looking at how we can find the sum of divisors when we have a prime raised to the power k. So if we have a prime p raised to the power k, the sum of divisors of p to the power k is equals to 1 plus p squared, plus up to p to the power k. So we'll be adding up to the highest power of the prime that we have there. But if the number that we are having is not of the form of p to the power k, then we can try to use the multiplicative property of the sum of divisors, which says that sigma m times n is equals to sigma m times sigma n if the greatest common divisor of m and n is equals to 1. So looking at the 12 here, we try to write it as a product of its prime vectors, and that will give us 2 times 2 times 3, which we can write as 2 squared times 3. These 4 and the 3, they are relatively prime. Therefore, we can use this multiplicative property. So we would have that our sigma 12 is equal to sigma 2 squared times sigma 3. We now go on and evaluate sigma 2 to the power 2. Sigma 2 to the power 2, using this formula here, we are having our p there is a 2. Our k will be the 2 as well, because we are having 2 to the power 2. So that will give us 1 plus p squared. The highest power there is a 2, so we'll go up to the p squared. So it will give us sigma 2 to the power 2 will be 1 plus 2 plus 2 squared. And that will give us 1 plus 2 plus 4, which gives us a 7. I now go on to sigma to the power 3. Sigma to the power 3, 3 is a prime number there, so it's just 3 to the power 1. So using this formula here, taking our p to be the 3, the k is the 1, would be having that sigma there would be 1 plus p, because we go up to the highest power. The highest power that we are having for 3 to the power 1 is 1, so it's 1 plus p. So whatever, sigma 3 is equals to 1 plus 3, which gives us a 4. Now substitute these values of sigma 2 squared and sigma 3 into this formula, and we would have that sigma 12 is equals to 7 times 4, which gives us a 28. So we are having the sum of divisors of 12 is 28. I now move on to the second one there, the sum of divisors of 2022. So the first step there, I will write it as a product of its prime vectors, and would have that is equals to 2 times 3 times 337. The 2, the 3, and the 337, they are relatively prime. So we can use this multiplicative property, and we have sigma 2022 is equals to sigma 2 times sigma 3 times sigma 337. We go on and evaluate sigma 2. For sigma 2, the 2 is a prime number. So we are saying in this formula here, our p is a 2, our k is a 1. So we are only going to up to this part here, 1 plus p. So sigma 2 is 1 plus 2, which gives us a 3. For sigma 3, using this formula here, the 3 is a prime number and our k is a 1. So we are going up to the first power here, 1 plus p. So it will be sigma 3 is equals to 1 plus 3, which gives us a 4. Then for the next one, sigma 337. 337 is a prime number. So we can use this formula here. We'll be taking our p to be the 337. The k will be a 1, and we'll be going up to this sum, because you're going up to 1, because it's just raised to the power 1. So it will be 1 plus p. So sigma 337 is 1 plus 337, which gives us 338. So substitute the values of sigma 2, sigma 3, sigma 337 into this formula here, and whatever, 3 times 4 times 338, which gives us 4056. So what you're having there is the sum of divisors of 2022 are 4056.